everyone, so I'm wearing a hat today, so deal with that. A long time ago, I made a video, I can't remember exactly what the video title was, and in the comments section of that video, somebody said to me that he hates how people say that lucid dreaming cannot occur in non-REM, or it only occurs in REM. Most of us lucid dreaming YouTubers will only talk about lucid dreaming in REM sleep, and there is a reason behind this. Even if they don't know why, there is a legitimate reason. It is true that we do dream in non-REM sleep. However, as the studies have suggested, when people wake up from non-REM sleep, their dreams tend to be very mundane, very lifeless, very energy lacking. And usually when people dream in non-REM sleep, it's because they are in the early hours of the morning. When you're in the early hours of the morning, your REM period is so much larger and therefore your dreams are so much longer, as we discussed in the last video. So if you're having these really long detailed dreams in the early hours of the morning, then chances are there is a little bit of overlap between the non-REM stage and the powerful dream-rich REM stage. If, however, we were to get rid of the data that we've got and we just make up some new data for the sake of argument of this video, let's just say that it is possible to dream in non-REM and you do it in every single non-REM stage. The chances of being lucid within this stage is very slim, because in non-REM, you're separated into three different stages of non-REM. There's stage one, stage two, and stage three. And the brainwave activity that you associate with these stages are fast, medium, slow. So when we're in slow wave sleep, our brain is very relaxed, deep state of relaxation. When we're in stage one, we're in a very fast, quick-paced sleep stage. Our brain waves are very active. And then stage two, it's kind of the buffer bit in between. If we were to dream in this section, then we would only have really the first two non-REM stages to be able to become lucid, because the stage three is far too deep and far too relaxed for our cognitive brain to actually kick in. So if we were to dream in those three stages, then you'd only have a very small chance of being lucid, because these two stages are so small. And this third stage is quite large, but again, as I mentioned, it is, you know, slow wave sleep, so it's very difficult to become consciously active in your slow wave sleep. Some of you may be confused about non-REM sleep and naps. Naps are not non-REM sleep. They do have a very small section of non-REM sleep, but if you were to take a nap during the middle of the day, then predominantly that is going to be full of REM. So you, as a lucid dreamer, may experience some sort of lucid dream in a nap during the day, but that's only because our brain is wired in the day to become alert and active, so that you can go into a dream and then it kicks into REM quite quickly. And you may even have found this, even if you don't take naps, when you're just relaxed in the afternoon and your imagination is just, your daydreaming powers are just kicking into overdrive. That's because our brains are wired to become alert during this point of the day. There are also these two other things that happen in stage two of non-REM sleep, and they're called sleep spindles and K-complexes. Basically, a sleep spindle is a very rapid period of brainwave activity, and a K-complex is a very slow one, but the amplitude of the wave form that you find in the, what do they call it? Somnograph? Polysomnograph. The polysomnograph that you find, you get a sleep spindle that's very, but then you get a K-complex. And if we were to assume that you could be lucid within stage two of non-REM, then I'm not sure how those two activities of your brain would influence your sleep or influence your lucidity. It would be interesting to find out, but I'm not sure how realistic it is to be able to find out. So to combat the whole, I don't know whether or not to try and lucid dream in non-REM, just don't bother. Stick to your normal lucid dreaming patterns, so you go to sleep and you try and be lucid within REM. If you're trying to custom tailor your brain to lucid dream in non-REM, A, I don't know how possible that is, and B, you need REM sleep. People die if they don't have REM sleep. Legitimately die. So that's it for this video. I do want to give a quick announcement today about the Patreon page and the YouTube memberships. Thank you very much. The Patreon page, if you're a $7 or more tier, then you will have your first podcast out now so that you can look up on that podcast. Also, if you're a $4 or more or you are a YouTube member, then we're going to have a live stream exclusive for this month at some point. It was going to be yesterday, but looking at how many people are still trying to transition to the new Patreon page, I thought we'll just wait for a little bit. Also with the channel, a lot of people have been messaging me about not being able to see all of the videos that I make, so I've changed the upload schedule from every day to every other day back again. That's not because of the lack of subscribers that I'm gaining, it's purely because people aren't watching my videos because there are too many of them. And if I'm making too many of them, I'm trying too hard then, aren't I? I also have figured out what I'm going to do with the second channel. I just need to plan it and then execute the plan, but you will like it. If you want to subscribe, link in the description box below. So, until 2 days' time,